Mark, a former mayor found himself in the middle of this storm's wrath.
He did. I'll have that for you coming up in just a second. I want to set the scene. First of all, if you don't know where Tuscaloosa is, it's in west central parts of Alabama. It's about an hour southwest of Birmingham. You can still see the scene. It's really everywhere that you turn. Now, the interesting thing about tornadoes, I mean, it's the path, and this was a very, very wide path of a tornado, about a half mile to a mile wide as it moved through Tuscaloosa. Everywhere you go through there, that's where you see the damage. And you know what? We're getting a lot of Facebook responses and people calling and want to know, well, what can people in Wisconsin do? Well, I think the number one thing you probably can do is give to the Red Cross.
Helping to serve the first responders and the community, people that are in need for food and water, as well as find out what the medical needs are in the area.
We were supposed to be spending time with her daughter tonight, family-wise, for a wedding rehearsal dinner. Because of the devastation and everything that's gone on, that has been postponed or possibly canceled, and it just fed 800 and something people with the food from the rehearsals.
I was the mayor since 81 to 205. I live right here in the middle of the block, and thank goodness I was out of town. I've been through a lot of disasters as mayor here, and but this is the worst I've seen. You know, the streets were just covered. You couldn't even tell where the streets were, let alone anything else. I had a hard time trying to find my house when I went out yesterday for a few minutes, and it's a good thing I was out because I'd have never made it. I mean, the whole inside, the door frame, I pulled away the closet doors and the next room and everything else, and it's just complete disaster. I'm 86 years old, and every morning when I get up, I thank the Lord that I've got another day coming.
There are not words to describe. I mean, just seeing the paper flying around and all that's going on and all the families and everyone that's been impacted, there are no words to describe this.